An unknown radioactive element decays into non-radioactive substances. In 30 days, the radioactivity of a sample decreases by 12%. We want to find the exponential decay model for the decay after T days. We want to know what the half-life of the sample is. Then also, when will a sample of 50 milligrams decay to 10 milligrams? So to model this situation, we're going to use the exponential growth and decay function, P of T equals P sub 0, times e raised to the power of k times t, where p sub 0 is the initial population, k is going to be the decay rate, and because we have decay, k should be negative, t in this case will be the time in days, and p of t will be the remaining amount of radioactive substance after t days. Let's start by finding the exponential decay model. This one's a little tricky because it doesn't give us a starting amount and ending amount after 30 days. It just says that the amount decreases by 12%. So we can start with any amount that we want. Let's just let P sub 0 equal 1, meaning this could be 1 pound, 1 gram, 1 milligram, whatever. But if we decrease this by 12%, that means 88% would be left, so we can let P of T equal 0.88. If we decrease 1 by 12%, we'd be left with 0.88. And this decrease takes 30 days, so t is equal to 30. So now we can substitute these values into our exponential decay model and determine the value of k, our exponential decay rate. So we want to solve the equation 0.88 equals 1 times e raised to the power of k times t, but t is 30, so we have e raised to the 30k. Now, of course, this 1 here is not going to change anything, so let's go ahead and write this as 0.88 equals e raised to the power of 30k. This is one nice benefit from using 1 as the initial amount. And now to solve this exponential equation, we'll take the natural log of both sides and then apply the power property of logarithms on the right side, so we'll move this 30k to the front. So now we want to solve the equation natural log 0.88 equals, this would be 30k times natural log e. A lot of times textbooks leave off this natural log e. The reason for that is because it's equal to 1. Remember, natural log is log base e. So in exponential form, e raised to the power of 1 is equal to e. And that's the reason why this is equal to 1. And multiplying by 1 doesn't change anything, so now we have natural log 0.88 equals 30k. So to find the decay rate, we'll divide both sides by 30. We'll get a decimal approximation for this quotient. We do want to include quite a few decimal places for accuracy. So natural log 0.88 divided by 30. If we use 6 decimal places, we would have negative 0.004261. Which means for this situation, the exponential decay model would be P of T equals P sub 0 times e to the power of negative 0.004261 times t, where t is the time in days. So this is the first part of our question. Now we want to find the half-life of the radioactive element. So again, here's our exponential decay model. Half-life is the amount of time it takes for half of the material to, the half-life would be the time it takes for half of the radioactive material to decay to non-radioactive material. So again, what's a little tricky about this question is they don't tell us how much we're starting with, but that just means we can start with any amount that we want. So if we let P sub 0, again, equal 1, this could be 1 pound or 1 gram or 1 whatever, then the amount of material that's still radioactive after T days is going to be half of 1, which would just be 0.5 or 1 half. And then our goal is to determine how long this would take or solve for T. Remember, now we do have the value of K, though, so we will only have one unknown. So we want to solve the exponential equation. 0.5 equals 1 times e raised to the power of negative 0.004261 times t. So this is very similar to the last problem now. Remember, multiplying by 1 isn't going to change anything. So we can write this as 0.5 equals e raised to our exponent. And now we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation, apply the power property of logarithms here, so this moves to the front. So now we have natural log 0.5 equals negative 0.004261 times natural log e, but remember that is equal to 1, so I'm going to go ahead and leave it off this time. So now we can solve for t by dividing by this decimal coefficient. All this simplifies to 1t. So t is equal to this quotient here, which we'll get a decimal approximation for. If we round this to the nearest tenth, this would be 162.7 days. Now I should mention there is a shortcut formula for half-life. You can calculate half-life quickly if you know the exponential decay rate by calculating the natural log of 0.5, or if we wanted to, 1/2 divided by k, which can also be expressed as negative natural log 2. Remember, to go from here to here, we could write natural log 1/2 as natural log of 2 raised to the power of negative 1, then apply the power property of logarithms, so you can move this to the front. So this is equal to negative natural log 2. I don't really like to use this shortcut formula, though, because you can easily solve this problem without having to memorize another formula. And doing it this way, you understand actually what's happening. Now let's take a look at the last question. The last question asks, when will a sample of 50 milligrams decay to 10 milligrams? So for this question, the starting amount is 50 milligrams. The ending amount, or P of T, is equal to 10 milligrams. We want to know what T would be. So we're going to set this up just like we did the last two questions. So P of T is 10, P sub 0 is 50. We have e raised to the power of negative 0.004261 T. We'll isolate the exponential part by dividing both sides by 50. So we have, this would be 0.2 equals e raised to our exponent. Again, take the natural log of both sides of the equation, apply the power property of logarithms. So this is the third time we've solved a problem like this. Natural log 0.2 equals negative 0.004261 t times natural log e, which is equal to 1, so we'll leave that off. So now we'll just divide by our coefficient on both sides of the equation. This simplifies to t, and now we'll get a decimal approximation for the time it takes for 50 milligrams to decay to 10. And we should recognize this time should be quite a bit longer than the half-life from the previous question. So natural log 0.2 divided by our exponential decay rate. Going to take approximately 377.7 days. I hope you found this example helpful.